Hi everyone, I've just taken some time to prepare a short voiceover PowerPoint for you on balancing, because I know it's an area that a lot of you struggle with your financial plan, and something that you get right at the very end, but it's sometimes too late to talk to me about it, so hopefully this will be some help to you. The first thing we need to talk about is what we're trying to balance, and having a good understanding of that really helps you in working out what you're trying to do. So I know the accounting equation is owner's equity equals assets minus liability. So that owner's equity figure is also called the net assets figure. The accounting equation in our first year always balances in our opening balance sheet, because we know that all we have to do is have assets minus liabilities, we've got our net assets or our owner's equity figure. What further complicates things is when we move into the second year or the end of the first year in our financial plan. In subsequent years, it becomes a little bit more difficult. What are we trying to do? We're trying to make sure that the owner's equity figure at the end of the year reconciles with or equals the changes between the owner's equity at the beginning of the year and all of the transactions that have taken place during the year. So our closing owner's equity should equal our opening owner's equity plus our profit minus our loss, minus any drawings that have been taken from the business, also minus any revaluations to assets, minus tax. So this has to equal with the balance at the end of your net asset figure. And when we're looking at our balance sheet, we're looking at these two figures here. So we're looking at these net asset figures here, which is our total assets minus our liabilities, this $1,075,000 figure here, and we need it to reconcile with this end-of-year owner's equity figure. And you can see here that the reconciliation's been detailed. So in the beginning of the year, we had about $900,000 worth of owner's equity, the business has made a profit, we've got a positive revaluation of some assets, and they've taken out the drawing there. You see, this is the net profit figure. So in this example, this figure has already had tax deducted. So there we can adjust our equation, just put in the net profit figure. So you either use your net profit figure or you use your operating profit and then take the tax out of the equation there to end up with that balance. What we do with double entry accounting is doing two entries for every transaction. So more often than not, when we can't get a balance between our net asset figure and our reconciled owner's equity or reconciled net asset figure, it's because a transaction, one or more, has been incorrectly allocated. So we've allocated perhaps one side of it and not the other side. So remember, each transaction affects the accounts in two ways. So a revaluation increases the asset value and increases the asset revaluation reserve. A machinery purchase increases the asset, and we have that in our depreciation schedule, and it also decreases cash at bank. If we have sales during the year that generate a profit, this increases the cash we have in our bank account and increases the profit in the reconciliation. If we take out a new loan, we increase cash, but we also increase liabilities. Here's a bit of a demonstration about how it might look in your reconciliation part of your balance sheet. Something known as equity in the partnership. If we've got a capital contribution, so if the owners of the business have put in some capital from elsewhere, we have that input in there. We have plus or minus the net profit, so the profit that the business has made there. If that's a loss, obviously that gets deducted. We take away the less any drawings that the business has taken, plus or minus any asset revaluation, which in the case of your business plan is likely only to be an upward revaluation of land as you progress through the business planning process. We have something slightly different for a company. The equation remains the same. The names of things are slightly different. So instead of capital introduced, we have capital raised by share issue. Now this is unlikely in the lifespan of your plan, 5-year business plan. Net profit or loss, as we've explained earlier. Here we don't have drawings, we have dividends paid, because that's the way that companies distribute their profit to their business owners. And we also have the net Yes, it will evaluation above as before. For family trust, we have beneficiaries equity at the bottom of our balance sheet. Again, the opening balance, we're adding or deducting the profit or the loss. Remember, it's net profit. So if we're using an operating profit figure, we also have to make the adequate adjustment for the calculation. Minus the distributions that have been made to the beneficiaries, that the profit is distributed from the family trust, and plus or minus the net asset revaluations, again in this case probably land. And then you end up with the beneficiary's equity. So you recall from your earlier studies that the closing statement of financial position should automatically balance, providing all transactions which occurred during the year have been properly accounted for. But it doesn't balance and some error has occurred in the financial analysis. One thing you do need to remember though is the concept of materiality. If you're dealing with $5 million figures or $2 million figures and you have a non-balancing of about $60, $70, even a couple of $100, in all likelihood you've probably balanced the balance sheet. And the problems are just due to a rounding error, potentially to do with the cost of production or maybe a cents per kilogram figure or something like that, which has thrown it out of balance. Not, if you are a nice round number, $20,000 out of balance, then you probably need to look for figures that are around that $20,000 mark that may have been misallocated. However, you're likely to be out in a couple of different ways, some perhaps under and some perhaps over, and looking for the specific amount that you're out by is unlikely, therefore, to lead you to the right answer. So how do we manage balancing? Set up a check cell within the Excel spreadsheets to actually just see if the those two cells are equal, the answer should be zero. If it doesn't balance, there's a few areas I'd like you to look at first. One of them is tax, so make sure you haven't confused your GST with your PAYG tax or your income tax that you're paying. Also look at your evaluations and make sure if you've increased the value of any asset, that that's actually captured, the increase in value is actually captured in the revaluation reserve. Also, if you've got livestock accounts, just double check that they're adequately accounted for and correctly accounted for. So go back to the learning materials, check that you've done this properly. Make sure your drawings are correctly allocated, if included, and where there's no confusion between drawings and wages, because we know that wages are an expense and should be captured within the profit and loss, and drawings are a share of profit distribution. So wages are tax deductible and are included as an expense in our profit and loss, whereas drawings show up on the balance sheet as a withdrawal of equity in the business. Both of them within roughly the same place within your cash flow budgeting because the cash exits the business in the same way. It's about whether the wages reduce our profit or the drawings reduce our equity in the business, and that's how it affects that calculation. So good luck with it, and hopefully you get to a nice balancing figure or a small rounding error by the end.